All right, we're standing here in Victory Lane at SpeedFest. It almost should be named Kyle Busch Fest because this guy just dominated this race. Kyle Busch, tell me about this super late model race. It was 250 laps of you kicking everybody's ass.
Well, it was fun. You know, we had a great race car. Got to thank Bon Suss and Chris Gabehart, all the guys that do such a great job. They work hard, and we work them very hard in order to get good race cars out of this camp, and they did a good job here this weekend, so real proud. And you know, it was a fun race, really. You know, we got up to the lead early there and led the first half, and then we had to move back to fifth for the second half, but it was still fun to be able to work our way back up through there and had some exciting moments there in the midpoint, so it was cool, man.
Tell me about that lap traffic, because it was a little chaos out there trying to get through some of that lap traffic.
It was. You know, there were some slow cars up high, and Steven and myself were trying to pass them, and then, you know, I ended up getting into his door a little bit. Luckily, I was up far enough alongside of him where it didn't turn him sideways or anything, but my car was a little bit tighter than I would have liked, but, you know, the car had great forward bite up off on the second half of the race, so really worked well.
This weekend has kind of been your weekend here at the racetrack. Let's flash back to a little bit earlier. You were actually chasing Casey Roderick.
Yeah.
There was a little contact there. He went around. He was okay with it. He said, hey, it happens. But from your perspective, what happened?
Well, I mean, it was a racing deal. Casey was working really well at the bottom of the racetrack, holding me off there. I couldn't get underneath him. So I tried working to the top side a little bit. And I got into turn one, looking to his outside. He stayed high a little bit on me, and I didn't check up quick enough, and I got in the back of him, spun him out. So totally my fault, didn't mean for it to happen, but coming down to crunch time with six or seven to go, whatever it was, you know, you had to make a move and try to win the thing. And our car wasn't great, but it was really good in the first half. I made some stupid changes to it for the second half, and they didn't work out. So unfortunately, we messed up that one, but came back here this evening.
You have fun at these short track races. You come out here, race the pro late model, super late model. This is kind of like playtime in your playground out in these races.
It is. You know, I like coming out here, though, and seeing some of the local talent and some of the new guys coming up through the ranks. Elliott's been really, really good, Chase Elliott. And Roderick's been really good. And, of course, you know, Steven. I know Steven really well, but you know, there's some other guys and gals that that race really well, and it's cool to always race against them and just kind of see what the fresh new talent looks like coming up through.
All right, and the last part of this race, you did have that five car behind you, Steve Wallace. I don't know, you guys have had some history on and off in the NASCAR side. Were you a little worried about that on some of those restarts?
Actually, I wasn't. You know, I forgot all about that. Now you bring it up, I should have been. But it turned out for the best, and we ended up okay.
Kyle Busch here in Victory Lane at SpeedFest. Once again, this guy is dominating the short track world.